Good morning, kings and queens. And this is Beyond the Walls Ministry. And I'm your minister, TJ Beatty. Today's nugget will be coming from John chapter 21, verses 1 through 6. And it reads, later, Jesus appeared again to the disciples beside the Sea of Galilee. This is how it happened. Several of the disciples were there. Simon Peter, Thomas, Nathanael from Cana in Galilee, the sons of Zebedee, and two other disciples. Verse 3, Simon Peter said, I'm going fishing. We'll come too, they all said. So they went out in the boat, but they caught nothing all night. At dawn, Jesus was standing on the beach, but the disciples could not see who he was. He called out, fellows, have you caught any fish? No, they replied. In verse 6, then he said, throw out your net on the right side of the boat, and you'll get some. So they did, and they couldn't haul in the net because there were so many fish in it. Today I want to talk about either you're going to do it with Jesus or don't do it at all. This morning, as we look at this book of John, chapter 21, we start out with the disciples. These disciples, this is like a deja vu moment. They're at the Sea of Galilee, a place where they've been before. This is like being back at home. You got Simon Peter, you got Thomas, you got Nathanael, you got the other disciples, you got the son of Zebedee, and they're here. And Simon Peter, who is the leader, who's the point man, Simon Peter decides to become impatient. He decides that, you know what, hey, I'm going to go fishing. You have to understand, Jesus had already told the disciples. He had sent them there in advance. And back in Matthew 28, he tells them that you are going to become fishermen of men. He tells them that. And that they should be here waiting. But Simon Peter says that he's going to go fishing. Now, don't get me wrong. There's nothing wrong with going fishing, but Simon Peter's job was never to be out fishing for fish. His job was to be fishing for men, to be bringing the lost souls to Christ. You know that what the same thing that you and I have been called to do. It's our job. It's a duty as Christians, as believers. We are to be going out fishing, bringing in lost souls, because everybody that knows anything, if you've ever been fishing, we have to understand that there is a way, a method to fish. You just can't go out there and stick your pole out and catch fish. Fish just don't come like that. You got to know the method. And only way to know that method is to know the 66 books, to know the Word of God, to have a relationship, to be studying, to be building. That's the only way. And when you understand the Word of God, you know the Word of God, you'll be able to go out and catch those fish. And Simon Peter, he says, I'm going to go fishing. Being a leader, the other disciples, what do they do? They go, they say, we'll go too. They follow him. As a leader, we have to understand that sometimes we're going to either lead people to the good or we're going to lead them to the bad. We're going to lead them to swim or we're going to lead them to sink. It's how you're leading. You have to understand that as leaders, we can affect how the people that are following with us. We have to understand that. We have to know that we've been called. To be leaders, then we need to make sure that we're operating under God's will. We're operating how God has told us to do it. Not interjecting ourselves, because when we do that, that is the moment that things go bad. That's the moment when things fall. That's when things get messed up. It's when we follow Jesus, when we do what his word tells us to do, that the path is made straight, that the road goes from being crooked to even. You know, we see it, verse 3 also, as it says, they all said, so they went out in the boat, but they caught nothing all night. That's kind of crazy that they caught nothing all night. Here they are, they're fishermen. These are not the average fishermen. These guys they're professionals. They've been here before. They know everything about this sea. You ever been to a lake, been fishing, and you cast out your net, you know exactly where the bream is hitting it. You know exactly where the catfish are hitting, where the bass are biting it. Because guess what? You've been doing this a while. You're not a rookie to it. You're not new to it. That's the same thing with these disciples. They weren't new to it. But because of their disobedience, because of their impatience, because of being led by a leader who was causing them to fall in this situation, they caught nothing all night. That's how it is. We have to understand that as ministers, as churches, as community, if we're not doing what God says, if we're not going out fishing as God has taught us how to fish, then guess what? There will be no souls that will come to Christ. You'll just be preaching. You'll just be in the pulpit, standing up, talking. You'll just be there singing, but nobody will be coming. There will be nobody that will be coming to the church. all of those that's after this loss, they'll still continue to be lost. You can't, because we can't just do it our way. We can't think it's because, well, I'm an awesome preacher. I'm a mighty man of God that I know the word of God that people are going to come. No. You can't start deciding how church is supposed to be. You can't create church your own way. God has already given us a layout. He's already given us the blueprint on how the church is supposed to roll, on how it's supposed to operate. But see, these disciples, they were being led by bad leadership. They're Simon Peter at the time. That's why they call his name in this book is Simon Peter, because it's an example of who Peter was before he was Simon. He's in his old ways. He's not operating as the Peter that we know, the one who loves God. He's operating in his old ways. But watch this right here. When we go to verse 5, it says, at dawn, Jesus was standing on the beach. See, that's how it usually is. We done messed it up. We done did it wrong. We decided we gonna do our own thing. And Jesus still comes and shows up and fixes things. At dawn, Jesus stands on the beach. But the disciples could not see who he was. He called out, fellows, have you caught any fish? One dialect says, he says, children. He says children because you're acting like children in this situation. You're not acting like spiritual leaders. You're not acting like one who's been following me, one who knows who I am. You're acting like children. He doesn't call them brothers. He doesn't call them disciples. He doesn't call them men of God. He calls them fellows, children. He says, have you caught anything? And their reply is no. It's really not a question. It's a statement. I know you have not caught anything because you decided to go out here and you want to be impatient when I told you to wait on me. You want to do it your way. That's usually what happened. You're trying to figure out why the church is still empty, why nobody is sitting on the pews, why nobody is coming. Because you're trying to build the church and do it your way. You want to do it. It's so much I in it. It's so much me in it, and not Jesus. And in verse 6, last, it says, then he said, throw out your net on the right side of the boat. Look at Jesus giving them instructions. And you'll get some. So they did, and they couldn't haul in the net because there were so many fish in it. Look what God does when you will be obedient. When you listen to God, he gives you more than you can imagine. He gives you an overflow. I'm not just talking about finances right here. I'm not just talking about in your health and strength. I'm talking about in everything that you do. But in this situation, particularly being fishermen of men, bringing souls to Christ. If you listen to God, if you follow God, if you honor his word, when you go out and you look for those fishermen, those men, those souls, those lost souls, when you go out fishing, he'll bring so many fish in, so many souls to you. All you got to do is be in position to cast your net. How you in position on today? All you need to be in a position where you can just cast your net. God says, just cast your net. And guess what? I'll bring them in. I'll reel them in. Even those fish that you didn't think that you could get, I'll bring them in. Watch this right here. Check it out. It also says that it was so many fish that the net didn't break. Those fish that they be tugging away, those heavy fish, those strong fish, those men that's out there that's unbelievers, that's being tough, that's been giving you that fit, they're coming at you in all directions. They give you so much backlash that you saying, you know what? I don't think I can get them. But God said, if you just cast your net, I'll bring them in. All you got to do is just be in position. Allow me to use you. Do how I want you to do it. I'll bring souls in. We have to be bringing souls of Christ. We've been called to be fishermen of men. We already know that there's plenty of work, but that labors are few. There's plenty of work for us to do out there. Are you ready to go to work? Not for the world, not for man, but for God. Then he said, throw out your net on the right side of the boat and you'll get some. So they did. And they couldn't haul in the net because there were so many fish in it. Today, my brothers and sisters, we have to know that we, especially us that live in Memphis right now, we understand that there's so much crime, so much sin is happening in our city. But it's up to us to be the examples, to be the light of God, be able to go into those dark places and be able to cast our net and bring in those unbelievers. We're not to be treating people like they're Samaritans. Like the Samaritan woman. We're not to be looking at or talking about people, but we ought to be making conversation. Being that example, doing what's outside the norm for Christ so that we can bring in those lost souls. But there may be somebody on today. There may be a lost soul. There may be you who's out there. That needs to be reeled in. You need to come to the net, to be caught by Jesus, to be his dearly beloved, to be his one and only. That may be you that's lost. And if that's you that needs to be pulled in, it needs to be brought in, needs to become saved, needs to be able to change your life, I'm saying on today, you can have that opportunity. And there may be somebody out there that already saying that, hey, I'm a believer. I believe in Christ, but I'm just not. I've been impatient. I've been disobedient. I have not been put in the right position so that God can use me, so that I can become a fisherman of men, so I can bring souls to Christ. And if that's you on today, you both can submit on today. You both can say this simple prayer that Lord, you are my God and I am your child. And that I submit to you. Lord, I believe that you died for my sins on today. That I want to be, that I believe that you rose the third day with all power in your hand. And that I want to be saved on today. I believe that if you said that on today, that you will be saved. That God will come into your life. He will do a brand new thing with you. That you will now be positioned. That you will be one of those fishermen of men on today. So I say on today, on this marvelous Monday, make it a habit on today to study the Word of God. Make it a habit to get into the Word of God so that you can be positioned. Make it a habit to know the Word of God so that when you come across those lost souls, that you can cast your net so that they can be like you and I, caught in the arms of our wonderful and our great and our loving and powerful Savior, Jesus Christ. Be blessed.
I need you to make a way out.